God, I just realized that this place, this room is so much more clear. When I'm making the live video, my voice was so much more clear. So I'm going to quick fast track this. We are going to do Yoga Mudra today, the Psychic Union pose. And I'm going to check which of the two videos that I made is better quality and keep that one. In Psychic Mudra, in Psychic Union pose or Yoga Mudra, we're going to be sitting up straight. I'm going to cup one hand, my left hand over the wrist of my right hand behind me while sitting up straight. And there's going to be bending over. So if you have back issues, please do not do this pose. Yoga Mudra is excellent for digestion, energy levels, constipation problems, and overall flexibility and toning of the body. What we're going to do is we're going to do our best to follow through the breathing pattern because in yogasans or yoga poses, there's a lot of benefit that comes with following the breathing pattern. Now, if you are not comfortable for whatever reason, it's okay to just continue your yoga pose with your normal breathing and do your best to follow along with me. So the breathing pattern is going to start with inhaling while we're sitting up straight. We're going to bend or turn over to our left. Then touch our knee, bend to touch our head to our knee, and then hold. When you're bending over, we're going to exhale. After we exhale and we've touched our head to the knee, we're going to hold that breath for 4 seconds, which will be double the amount of our inhaling and exhaling. If you cannot hold it for 4 seconds, you can hold it for just 2 seconds. That's okay too. When we come up, we're going to breathe in, then turn over to the other side, which is going to be my right side. Again, while bending over, I'm going to exhale, hold that breath for four, come up again, breathe in, and then bend over straight and attempt to touch my head to the floor. I'm just going to go as far as I can go, and you should do the same. And eventually, the more you do it, the more flexibility you will build. So now I'm going to scooch back and show you the pose. All right. I believe when I tested it, you were able to hear me even from here. So I'm going to cross my one leg over the other. You can do the complete yoga lotus pose also, where you cross both your legs over each other, or you can simply sit in just the regular cross-legged position. I'm going to cup my hands behind me, back straight, breathe in for 2 seconds. Turn to your left, shoulders are still straight. Now I'm bending down and breathing out. And then holding that for 4 seconds. I'm touching my head to my knee. Come up. While coming up, you're going to inhale back straight. Turn to the other side. Once again, we're going to be exhaling and attempt to touch our head to our knee. One, two, three, four. After holding for 4 seconds, I'm going to come up. I'm breathing in, holding that for now. And as I bend down, I'm going to exhale and attempt to touch my head to the floor in front of me as close to my legs as possible. Now my shoulders also shrug. One, two, three, four. Breathe in and let go. I'm going to show it to you once. You can look at it and then follow along. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Beautiful. I love this pose. It makes me feel very good. I did tell you in the previous video that I made that my next giveaway is on April 26th, but that's wrong. My next giveaway, big giveaway, is on April 20th. So stay tuned for more mindfulness videos. The next one is coming up on Monday. We're going to be taking a break on Sunday so that way you can catch up with the last 4 days of mindfulness that I did. And on Monday, we can attempt to do another yoga pose. Bye-bye. This is Rima Desai from the Guiding Star.